So now we are going to make draggable objects for when you're making a game. This can be done with either touch or a mouse. The only thing that you'd have to do is make sure that you include the touch input, as seen on my screen here. So let's see. I've set up a whole bunch of these black bars. Now I want my player to be able to grab them and bring them over to these land spots to make a movable platform, almost. So here's what I'm going to do. Just place them over here. And now I need to add a behavior. So I go ahead and I click all of these. I add the behaviors right here. First one I'm going to add is drag and drop. This is going to allow me to drag and drop my objects, which is neat, I guess. But let's give it a test run. I can now move it. Great. Still doesn't save me. So we go back. We need to add another behavior. So we are going to add the solid behavior. Let's see how it works now. So I click, I drag. Click and I drag. Oh. Oh my. Closer. But I want these planks to matter. At this point, it doesn't even really matter whether or not I have... Let's see. Ooh. Whoa. Teleportation. At this point, it doesn't even matter if they fall on the plank. So I'm going to reset this, because I want it to fall down. And for that, I'm going to do what's called physics. So physics is going to allow some different properties. Immovable, collision mass, prevent rotation, da, 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 da. I'm looking for gravity. Huh. I'm not seeing it just yet. So let's see. Let's run it just by activating physics. Oh, so now they're falling through the ground, which isn't great. But they are definitely interacting. So what I'm going to do now is just make sure these are all moved above the solid. So here I also double check, make sure that it does have the solid behaviors. Solid. Okay. Let's run. No good. So we go back. We click this object. Use collision polygon. Bounding box. Let's do that. Nothing. So I just had a few issues with trying to get these objects to be falling on each other, and that's because we need to do a little bit of editing to the objects. So any of my land platforms, I need to apply the physics property to it. And that way, these two objects will be able to interact. Now, the thing is, you want to set it to immovable. Why? Because if it's not set to immovable, then two objects with an equal mass will hit each other and move the same amount. So gravity will continually force it, and it'll just continue to move. So once I set it to immovable and I drop my platform, it's going to be draggable, droppable. Whoa. And we could even set up like a catapult or something like that. Interesting. Oh, just got to be careful. Okay. Let's see. And now we are able, to fill up the void. As long as we... Some of these I set on their own. So this one's like a magic one that doesn't move at all. In fact, I can click it and drag it to the exit. So if you are setting up a platform with the physics tab, you have to say unmovable, otherwise it'll fall to nothingness. In fact, let me just show you right here. I'm going to set this to no. I press play. And now I'm falling. And yeah, so that's just what happened. So you'll see I start falling at the beginning. And it's a little hard because it happens so quickly, but that's why you need to set any ground that you don't want to have flying around in the universe to... Yes. Cool thing that you could try is making, like, meteorites that fall down and they are movable. So you could have them almost with, like, a bullet type thing, or you can set gravity to them and have it randomly spawn. So every 0.25 seconds, you could have a... Well, let's do it. Let's make this happen. Layer 1. So I'm going to make a meteorite. Close enough. I'm actually going to go back and do little cracks. Cool. So now I'm going to move this object after I set up the behavior. I'm going to make it a solid and I'm going to apply physics to it. So now I go to my event sheet, speed boost page, add event, system. Every X seconds. We're going to make it every quarter. Actually, we're going to make it every tenth of a second. You have to say 0.1 seconds. We are going to generate an object. Okay, so create object. And here's what we're going to have to do. We choose the layer. We're going to pick the object that we want to create. And now I think, yeah, random. And we now have to give it a range. So it would be really helpful if I knew how large it was. But I'm just going to say zero. What is it? Range. 0, 100. And why? Let's do this at negative 150. So it will randomly generate every 0.1 seconds one of these sprites between 0 and 100x and negative 150y. I feel like this is going to be chaos. I like chaos. So I press play. And I press play again. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, so it's generating these things. Let's zoom out a little bit on our screen. Let's just shrink everything. Shrink our character. So we can see. Yeah, so it's really piling these things on. In fact, let's change the zoom of this. Outsize. You see that? Well, couldn't figure out the zoom off the top of my head, so I'm just going to extend it. So now I got 5,000 is the range of this. So I'm going to go to my speed boost event sheet. I'm going to change the range here from 0 to 5,000. Done. And now when I play, we should have... Every 0.1 seconds, it's spawning something. And you could almost make a level where you need to try and jump on the meteors. Ugh, failed. So anyway, that's just another thing you can play with. You can have these things kill you and not show up nearly as often as they do. Because this is a bit jarring. And right now my player is actually even stuck. So, yeah. This video, we made objects with physics, we created randomly spawning objects, and that way, oh, you can almost make a shield. So these are different attributes that you could include in your game, or not. It's your game. Happy making.